Paul has a 1995 Jeep Grand Cherokee with a 4-liter engine and the 42 RE transmission. He's having some transmission problems and anticipating a need to rebuild his engine soon. Moses, I'm ready to rebuild my 42 RE. I've read through the transmission section of the magazine and will do all the Sonax upgrades you mentioned. Sonax has a kit that includes all of them. Also in your article, you mentioned high performance parts, but you don't go into detail about what those parts are. And with so many master rebuild kits out there, I just don't have enough experience to choose, so I'm hoping you can help. My plans for the Jeep are daily driver and 2 or 3 expedition trips sprinkled throughout the year. I also drive a lot of gravel roads, fishing the small reservoirs and streams in northern Utah, Nevada, Wyoming, and Idaho during the summer. My expedition trailer is 3,500 pounds fully loaded. The Grand Cherokee totes around 4 of us. I am planning to build a 4.6 liter stroker in the next year, and I have a lot of questions for that, but I'll ask them when I'm ready to build. I plan on keeping the Grand Cherokee for some time. I like it, so I want this transmission to last. Paul, for openers, the 42RE transmission, as you've discovered, is a derivative 727 torque flight with an overdrive. The Sonax parts are an absolute must for upgrading, for making sure that the torque converter is being lubricated in park and that the front pump bushing receives fluid in park. All of those upgrades are a necessity. The Sonax parts that I talk about in the Automatic Transmission Workshop article are actually a necessity. They are not high performance parts or intended for getting heavy duty use out of the transmission, but rather for the survival of the transmission in stock form. During a rebuild, as you've discovered, the Sonax parts are an essential. There are additionally heavy duty parts that are available for truck pullers and heavy duty towing applications and things like that, billet input shafts, heavy duty bands, all kinds of components for the various RE transmissions, usually the ones that are involved with truck chassis and towing applications. So that said, for your purposes, I would do a quality rebuild with the Sonax upgrades to see that the transmission will survive. I wouldn't make any modifications because you have an electronic PCM interface between the transmission and the engine, and you want to make sure that that transmission shifts properly and functions properly. Aftermarket high performance upgrades would not make a lot of sense. You'll want to rebuild the torque converter, and when you do that, make sure they do a stock stall speed and don't get into exotic high stall converters or anything like that. As far as the parts you use to make sure that you do a quality rebuild, make sure that the parts are Kevlar with the bands, clutch discs that are like Raybestos or high quality, made in Israel or made in the USA parts are excellent. Other parts are knockoff parts from offshore. Shop around. Make sure that you have Kevlar-based or quality Raybestos traditional clutch linings on the discs and so forth. Be certain to soak the discs during assembly. Do the things that are required for a quality rebuild. If you do all of that, that 42RE transmission should last a very long time, even with a 4.6 liter stroker engine buildup. The 42RE was used with truck applications, and it's a rugged unit for a Grand Cherokee weight vehicle. Remember too that on all of the Chrysler RE and RH transmissions, and this would be Jeep and Dodge Ram truck applications and Chrysler rear wheel drive of any kind, that you do need to periodically adjust the bands. Band adjustment is a routine part of service, usually minimal. In fact, if you need to do a lot of adjustment on bands, you probably have a band problem. Keep in mind though, that is a routine part of service on the RE and RH transmissions.